Brian, this is an incredible time to be a basketball fan in Cleveland. Andre and I were talking about just the appreciation of the regular season that we haven't seen since LeBron's first tenure here. Mm-hmm. When you watch the Cavs play, Brian, how much better are they than you thought they'd be?
Well, I knew they'd be. I thought they'd be pretty good, but I wasn't sure how they would do just managing the difficulty in the Eastern Conference. You know, that first game of the year, they had that real tough loss to the Raptors, and I know they didn't have Garland for that game, basically, but I was like, well, that's the way it's going to be in the East, man. They can play really well and take some losses, and you're seeing that with teams like Miami and Chicago and Philly. You know, they're mm-hmm. taking some losses. But it's been the Cavs have been doling them out. And I got to tell you, so they got the two wins over the Celtics, and both were excellent wins. Mm-hmm. And I'm looking ahead on the schedule, guys. Friday night in San Francisco, Cavs Warriors, it's a big game. It's a throwback big game.
Yeah.
And, you know, we'll see. They got to play the Clippers tonight and then the Kings on Wednesday. It's not nothing's a given, but they should be in a great spot to go in and play that game. And, you know, I mean, I don't know if I want to say it's a potential finals matchup, but we should be paying attention to it because they're number two in defense in the league right now, which is not a surprise. That's what they do. But coming into yesterday, and I haven't seen the updated numbers, their core four. So we're talking about Mitchell, Garland, Mobley, Allen, core four, had played a total of 28 minutes together the entire season. And they were 7-1, and now they're 8-1. They played, you know, they looked good together yesterday, but especially in the second half. So when you chart that out and say that they've had so many injuries, but they've still been able to, you know, get victories. And look, they're 3-0 in overtime. So they've had a couple of games that probably could have gone either way that they've been able to take. But that's a sign of a good team. Yeah. So, you know, you watch Garland and Mitchell and you're like, that's super dynamic. I think they're going to have some challenges. They still have to get better scoring under pressure, mm-hmm. but they're shooting the outside shot really, really well. And they still have to get a little bit, I think they still have to make a move at some point to get some defensive wing help.
Dean Wade didn't do it for you?
No, he is doing it for me. He's really become a quality piece, but they do need one more piece. But obviously, look, I'm rambling a little bit here. They're off to an awesome start, and, you know, they were just flat out the better team. I mean, Jared Allen outplayed Anthony Davis in the second half yesterday.
He had some bad foul calls on him early. He probably would have, not to cut you off, he would have outplayed him all game, I think, if he wouldn't have got the terrible fouls early.
Yeah, I mean, LeBron had the audacity after the game to complain about the officials.
I know.
I was like, okay. they look good, guys. They just look really good. They're going to win a ton of games, and they still upwardly mobile. You know, they still going to have a good high quality role player, Ricky Rubio, coming in at some point here. And I think that there's room for them to make a move. We'll see how things develop, but they still should find a way to get another wing player. So, if you're a Cavs fan, you should be real excited about them right now. And, you know, sneakily looking towards Friday night.